Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes in the Sky. What's up this week? Last week, we looked at objects in Monoceros, the unicorn. Let's finish up in and around there, since the moon is out of the way this week. Begin at Sirius, the brightest star in the nighttime sky, which is easy to find nearly due south at 8 o'clock or so, and sits 20 degrees down and to the left of Orion's belt stars. Using binoculars, place Sirius to the bottom of the field. You should see these three fourth magnitude stars. These are Gamma, Iota, and Theta Canis Majoris. There's a slightly dimmer fifth magnitude star between them. Draw a line from Sirius through Theta. Those two stars are 5 degrees from each other, which will place them on opposite sides of a binocular field of view. Continuing in the direction of that line, move a similar distance, now placing Theta where Sirius just was. Now where Theta had been, you may spy a faint haze in your binoculars, although you may need to use averted vision to see it, but you'll likely need to use a finder on your telescope to locate this area and put some more aperture on it. Past Theta, you should see this small triangle of 6.5 magnitude stars. Now that haze is the open cluster Messier 50. At 16 arc minutes of angular diameter, it can handle medium magnification in many telescopes. It is near a trapezoid shape of 7th magnitude stars. Now the cluster resides some 3,000 light years from us, and is approximately 20 light years across, containing around 200 or so stars, some as bright as 8th and 9th magnitude, which means a telescope is likely needed to see it. Darker skies and dark adaptation will help you see more. But a neat color contrast in this cluster is the 7.8 magnitude red giant star, some 1,000 light years further off than the cluster itself. And now this week's dark sky fact. Even small amounts of light can disrupt your sleep. According to Dr. Joseph Mercola, even the tiniest bits of light in the room can disrupt your internal clock and your pineal gland's production of melatonin and serotonin. The use of sleep masks can help, but updating our outdated and wasteful lighting on our homes and on our streets will go a long way towards helping all of us sleep better. Okay, so again using binoculars and starting at Sirius, while this time moving towards Gamma, Canis Majoris, we'll be moving through an area of the Milky Way, and some fifth magnitude stars will be visible here in this area. Continue through this shape till you reach another fifth magnitude star. That is yet another far-off red giant, 3,400 light-years away. When you see this, just beyond it is going to be Messier 47, a somewhat large and sparse open cluster, but one with quite a few more brighter stars in it than Messier 50 had. Though small, it is much more easily visible in binoculars, and a telescope at low power will reveal more stars, at least that we can see. So use your magnified finder scope to hop here. With about a dozen suns at 8th magnitude or brighter in a span the size of the full moon, and keeping in mind this cluster is only 1,600 light years away, this cluster will be brighter but maybe look less impressive and somewhat unstructured. In addition, there are only about 50 or so cluster members, spread out over 12 light years of actual distance. And now an observing tip. 50mm aperture binoculars have more than 50 times the area of the fully dilated human pupil, allowing us to see 2 to 4 magnitudes fainter with them than no optical aid. Their 5 to 7 degree fields of view make them well suited to viewing comets, large star clusters, and sweeping the Milky Way. 5 planets are within 20 degrees of the sun this week, which leaves us only with Jupiter still near the Hyades and Taurus, with a nice double moon transit occurring on the 9th, and Saturn rising ever higher in the evening sky, hitting the sweet spot of 20 degrees altitude by midnight this weekend. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.